Imagine a little microscopic world of 100 trillion little bacterias and funguses and viruses living together in an enclosed space. More cells than there are human beings on this planet now and throughout history. All functioning together and living together in harmony. That little world, believe it or not, does exist. And it exists inside your body. 90% of the cells in your body are not you. Now, that doesn't mean that 10% of what you see when you look at yourself is you, because these little microbes, these microbial cells, are really, really small. They're much smaller than your cells. So it's not like 90% of your weight is not you, but 90% of the number of cells in your body are not you. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I am Andrew Tunstall, nutritionist and athlete, and I am going to teach you all about that little hidden world inside you and how vital it is for you to keep it healthy so that it can keep you alive. Now, what are all these things doing inside your body? Well, they're just living there, getting on with their lives, but they are absolutely vital to maintaining your metabolism and to keeping you alive. You wouldn't last very long without them. They are mostly, not all, but mostly in your gut, in your intestine, and one of their primary functions is to facilitate your process of digestion. There's an awful lot of food we eat that we actually wouldn't be able to digest if we didn't have these microbes helping us out and doing it for us. So they help with our digestion. They are very important to our general immunity to disease because they're good, healthy pathogens. They're not pathogens. They're good, healthy microbes that will fight and kill pathogens or dangerous microbes when they get into our gut. So it's a little army of biological warfare that we have on our side. They also guard against inflammation. They prevent inflammation from getting out of control, which boosts our immunity. And they produce a lot of antioxidants to keep us healthy. So there's the second function. The third really vital function is that they are responsible for the production of a lot of our hormones, like serotonin, which is your happy hormone, melatonin, which is your sleep hormone, dopamine, your motivation hormone, even adrenaline, your action hormone. So without them, you'd be have terrible hormonal imbalances and real mental health issues, and a lot of depression and anxiety is linked to an unhealthy microbiome, to unhealthy bacteria in your gut. So they are very important. Without them, we'd be in big trouble. And yet we do things that damage them all the time. Now, one of the big dangers to your microbiome is antibiotics. And so you should try not to take antibiotics unless you really need them, because your body's not able to fight an infection by itself. And then very often your doctor will prescribe antibiotics along with a probiotic, which you probably heard of. And if you don't know what that is actually giving you a boost of healthy microbes to replace the ones that the antibiotic is probably going to be killing. So be very careful about abusing antibiotics or using them too long. Stress is bad for your microbiome because of the production of cortisol, which is your stress hormone, and that hormone kills a lot of the healthy microbes in your body. Your diet generally is very bad because you can eat foods that destroy them, and you can also not eat enough food that replenishes them or feeds them. Okay, so we'll get to those things. Just living in a very clean, antiseptic environment, as we do now in the West, we're much more hygiene conscious, and in a lot of cases it verges on paranoia, especially since the COVID pandemic, where we've got into the habit of wiping everything down with disinfectant and alcohol wipes and things. And what we do is we kill all the microbes in our environment, so we don't have access anymore to new microbes to replenish the ones in our bodies. It's actually quite surprising how much of our gut microbiome comes from our environment and gives us defenses against germs that come from our environment. So please don't go outside and start licking the road. Why did I even say that? But being clean is one thing, but disinfecting everything to a point of obsession can be quite counterproductive to your health. Sleep deprivation. Your microbes need you to go to sleep so that you stop doing a lot of the things that you're doing when you're awake, so that they can have a bit of downtime and do some housekeeping and produce some hormones and get on with some of their more important jobs. They don't want to be focused, for example, on digesting food all the time. So that suits them when you go to sleep and you stop eating. That we will also get onto in a bit more detail. I mentioned food, but one of the worst things you can eat for your microbiome is, of course, as we say with everything, sugar. Their main food source is fiber. And you've heard that before. You've got to get your fiber, your roughage. Fiber is a special type of carbohydrate that we cannot digest. So it's not food for us at all, but it is food for our microbiome. So these little bacteria and funguses, they break down fiber to generate the energy that they need so that they can work for us. Pathogens, dangerous microbes that make us sick, they eat sugar. So there's a little bit of evolutionary genius for you. Feed your healthy microbiome with fiber. Do not feed the dangerous ones by eating sugar. So how do we fix this? Well, I'm going to do another video. The second video in this is microbiome part one. Go to microbiome part two, where I will explain to you how you can maintain a healthy microbiome, what to eat, what to do, and what not to eat, and what not to do. So thank you for watching. Hit a like on this video, share it with somebody who you think might get some use out of it, and subscribe so you don't miss our new content.